To protect their crops, farmers are in a constant battle against harmful insects, weeds, and fungi. In 2012 alone, farmers spent nearly $56 billion on pesticides. However, current pesticides present many environmental and health risks. After pesticides are sprayed onto crops, the rain can wash them off and cause toxic accumulation in the soil and groundwater, damaging aquatic ecosystems and potentially finding their way into humans. High levels of pesticide exposure in humans has been associated with respiratory problems, neurological damage, and cancer. But with only 3% of the world's land suitable for farming, a rising global population, and increased crop loss from pests in a warming climate, it's essential that growing and harvesting crops is as efficient as possible. How can current pesticides be improved? Soybeans are one of the world's most important crops as a source of protein and oil, used to produce animal feed, a variety of food products, and biodiesels. Soybeans rely heavily on pesticide use due to an aggressive fungus called Asian soybean rust. The fungus creates reddish-brown lesions on the leaves, and it has been responsible for up to 80% crop loss. Currently, soybean rust is treated with synthetic chemical fungicides. These fungicides need to be applied repeatedly to counteract the rain, wind, and other environmental conditions that reduce the crop's protection. However, with overuse, the fungi is more likely to evolve resistance, making the pesticide ineffective. This insensitivity has already eliminated a previous class of fungicides, and it calls for a solution that doesn't confer resistance. To address soybean rust and the problems with synthetic pesticides, scientists have proposed a new pesticide design. The pesticide molecule is genetically engineered to consist of two peptide domains, an anchoring peptide that binds to the leaf and an antimicrobial peptide that kills the fungus. The anchoring peptide, called thanatin, THA, embeds itself into the leaf. Leaves are surrounded by a waxy structure called the cuticle, consisting of hydrophobic compounds that creates a water permeability barrier. Thanatin is an amphiphilic peptide, meaning it has both hydrophobic and hydrophilic regions. Scientists believe hydrophobic interactions between the thanatin and the waxy cuticle cause the peptide to stick. To evaluate the persistence of THA on the leaf, scientists first tag THA with enhanced green fluorescent protein, or EGFP. When exposed to light in the ultraviolet to blue spectrum, EGFP is excited and emits green light, allowing scientists to see and track the THA on the leaf. Next, scientists sprayed both soybeans and barley with the EGFP-THA peptides and an EGFP peptide control and left them outside. After 3 days, during which the plants endured 4 rain events, 1 light, 2 moderate, and 1 heavy, only 2% of the control EGFP remained on the soybeans, while 40% of the EGFP-THA persisted. Barley achieved even greater persistence. These results show the THA peptide can remain in the leaves in rainy conditions, which could reduce the risk of pesticide runoff into the ecosystem. An anchored peptide would also reduce the number of pesticide applications needed, meaning less overall pesticide would be used. The second component is the antimicrobial peptide dermaseptin. Dermaseptin originates from frog skin, where it acts as a defense peptide to kill bacteria, protozoa, and fungi by forming a helical structure and rupturing the cell membrane. Scientists attached dermaseptin to the anchor protein THA and sprayed the fusion onto soybean leaves before inoculating with soybean rust. The result was a 30% decrease in soybean rust symptoms, corresponding to an approximate 20% increase in yield. An advantage of dermaseptin is that it's a natural antimicrobial, which does not seem to harm mammalian cells, meaning it's unlikely to harm humans if exposed. Furthermore, since dermaseptin interferes with the fungus membrane itself rather than disrupting the fungi's internal metabolic or growth processes, there's less chance of developing resistance. This dipeptide pesticide design requires much more investigation into the production of the peptides and its effect on humans before widespread usage. Additionally, enzymes might be needed to remove the pesticides from plants. However, the basic design has broad applications. Since nearly all terrestrial plants possess a similar cuticle structure, the anchoring protein could theoretically be applied to any land plant. The antimicrobial dermaseptin could also be exchanged for another agent, such as copper, which is already used as an organic fungicide in wine-producing grape vineyards. The design does not impair photosynthetic activity, but it eliminates the need to genetically modify the soybeans themselves and could reduce contamination into the environment. With a host of other advantages, this pesticide could be a smarter way to reduce pests and protect crops.